Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are here. It is Wednesday. I am GM Jared, and it's time to be bad. We are Bedlam and Discord. As always, I am surrounded with an amazing cast whose sole job it is to make me look good. And they do a fine job of it. We've got Adam Rady down there. We've got Tracy Hearn. We've got Nathan Andrasek. And we've got James Chu. And we're ready for adventure. Also, note, we have 4 episodes left until our season break, so time to buckle up, because we're getting ready to drive this thing into excitement. You can drive shows, right?
That's how shows work. Oopsie can drive shows.
Oopsie drives, yes.
Oopsie exactly. Drive show.
Exactly. All right. Little housekeeping. The DAT network, as you see by this bar below on the very bottom of the screen, not now, but before it went to this one, we are on a quest to 400 subs. And we can get it with your assistance. If you're enjoying the content we've been dropping, please consider subbing. Remember, if you're an Amazon Prime member, you can link your Amazon and your Twitch, and you get a free sub every month. Let's see, what else we got here? That's the main thing that I wanted to make sure you know about. If you remember from last week, we had a cutaway just as the action was getting good. I have a feeling I may get to send one or two of these guys to Acker's collection of the dead. So without further delay, it's time to dim the lights, get your snacks, and settle in. All right. Also, I think Adam Rady might be frozen there, but let's do it. Under Captain Brenna Shaw kneels down to investigate the darkened mortar in the corner of the potentate's sparse counting room. Just outside the door, 2 palace guards stand uneasy, glancing back and forth at each other. They won't enter this room. Word is spread around the keep. The counting room is haunted. Already having claimed lives, faint beating and scratching and low wails have been heard emanating from within. Brenna moves towards the silver and gold scales on the table in the center of the room. She places one of the starburst iron counterweights onto one side of the scale. Tick, tick, tick. The number 7 appears. Brenna reaches down and places another of the identical counterweights onto the scale. Tick, tick, tick. Elsewhere, the bizarre little round creature plods down the reflective black hallway. Its sapphire-colored eyes atop its 6 eye stalks bounce and flop with each footfall as its 2 stubby clawed legs plod down. It approaches a large winged woman with a serpentine body and flowing white hair. The tippy taps of its feet as it waits to deliver its message with a kind of malicious glee.
We have broken through, mother!
A young dwarven girl, no more than 7, sleeps uneasily in an oversized tufted chair. Surrounding her mouth are the dried remnants of boysenberry pudding. A stuffed toy owlbear rests, nuzzled in between her arms. A worried father takes a blanket from the bed and places it over her. The dwarven man with salt and peppered beard continues pacing around the room. At every footstep or approach, he glances up towards the doorway with a glint of hope in his eyes, only to once again be devastated. They'll find him, he keeps muttering to himself. They promised. He turns to glance out of the window. How could she run like that? Thordis never would have left her. And those kids, they don't know what they're doing. She's old now, not as spry nor as quick. What could she realistically do? No, better to head back and give warning where it's due. After all, Shadowcloak has made a living getting out of tight places and bad situations. Why should this be any different? Still, she said she loved Thoris, and though he could not return the words, the sentiment was there. How could she just run? How could she live with herself? But the order must be told. As the body of an old dwarven man careens through the air, blasted backwards and through the now shattered doorway by a monstrous purple and green tentacle extending through a pulsing rip in the world, 4 figures find themselves in a moment. Beaten and depleted, the 4 stand breathing, barely having caught their breath from the crystalline and glass golem that has just shattered, raining shards of sharpness down onto them. The elf has already fallen, twice, only to be revived and pressed back into battle. Even the best laid plans fall apart, and this was not the best laid of plans. The giant appendage rears back and prepares to strike anew. Sinew and ichor drip from the lesions and cracks in its flesh. Suction cups on the feeder resemble more of an animal's maw, complete with spine teeth and froths of sputum and slobber. Roll initiative. But first, let's read comments.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So much is already happening.
Yeah. It's an adventure.
A lot of people like the art, Jared.
That was good.
A lot of love for the art.
Our artist, EJ Styles, over on Fiverr is amazing. If you need art done, she's super quick and really good at it.
Yes.
Real good. Scott DiNuzzo said, it's going to be a shame when Dante has to tell that poor child Gampy is dead. And he going to have to do that because Miramath going to be dead too, and he's not doing it then.
Why you don't make promises?
Yep. It's Lucas Martinez. Do you want to read this one, Dante?
One second. If Dwell Stone Rage don't find pudding in this episode, I'm never watching this show again. Don't you worry, buddy. I got a nice surprise for you.
Well, now Dante knows how to make pudding, so he can pass that down to people throughout the years. Gary Bones says he'll be back. Of course he will. He's Gary Bones, and he's got, like, mm-hmm. the best name in all of it. I love it so much. We had some follows from, I'm not going to pronounce this right, T-Sapke00, Zionizzy, Xander Darks. We also had a resub from Torger in CA.
Yeah.
For the fourth nice. Yay. And if you guys remember, you are holding on to the rest of your bonuses from last time.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I remember.
Those who still have.
Which one? Those bonuses. Who still have them.
I don't have.
You might need them.
I used mine.
Crossbones says Rady is muted. DiNuzzo says, dang it, Rady is unfrozen. So I don't know what they really want from Rady in that situation. They either want him muted or they want him frozen. Or maybe they just want him frozen, but you can still hear him.
We may never know.
We may never know. But we want comedy from Rady. That's fair. That's fair. Speaking of that, I don't know that we've heard Rady, so let's check on him and see what's going on. Send a type message here.
Where is he? The silent road.
What is running through Dante's mind right now?
I mean, watching that old man sail through the air, he's mostly concerned about that, and then worried about never showing his face in the city again, and just kind of walking into the woods if this old man passes away, so he doesn't have to deal with the consequences of his actions.
So you make promises to children and then run from them. Got it.
Only if they do not go through.
Got it. What's Milva thinking about witnessing all this chaos?
What the hell is that giant tentacle thing that's got him or had him? Like, what? What is this? And is this danger? Are we all going to die, basically? It's clearly danger, but... We'll see.
Well, I mean, we'll see. This old guy was clearly an adventurer. And so he's clearly higher level than you guys.
That's true. That's true.
So what about Miramath? What's Miramath thinking about?
He's remembering back to this very, very famous elf who had this elf was like a higher up in the community, a foreman, like a boss or something, who would in certain times, sing out the call that was needed, and would just go, "Baby, we were born to run."
All right.
So and that would be the signal for the elves to just book it out of there, because this is a fight we can't win right now.
Okay.
So right. Miramath is remembering that song from the boss.
The odds this works.
A voice from beyond.
Can anybody hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
You're a little quiet, but we can hear you.
Oh, well, I don't know that Channel. I can do anything can about quiet.
You're getting louder.
Oh, you're getting louder now. Maybe you just warm up the vocal cords.
Oh, yeah, I just had to get them warm.
Yeah.
Sorry about that, everyone. Are we dead?
No,
we're about to be.
We're doing a mental health check-in.
Okay.
We just checked in with everyone else on kind of what their situation and what they were thinking about was. What's Dark thinking as he sees this giant tentacle blasting forth?
Day spa. He's thinking about the day spa.
Always the day spa.
Yeah, he's interested in that and all that it has to offer. You know, he's just, this was always a mistake. Dark never really wanted to come, but now he's here. And, you know, tentacles were not something he signed up for. So, I don't know. He's probably pretty scared. But, you know, luckily, I think he's the furthest away from all of this combat currently. So I think he's probably not quite as concerned as everybody else in the immediate moment. But, yeah, he'll definitely be a big squirty cat if the tentacles decide to come for him.
That tracks. You are the furthest away and the quickest to get out. Though we've established that Jonte will make promises to children and break them, so I don't know that he'll be paying for your spa treatment.
Oh yeah, no, he's not a child. He's never gonna actually give me my spa treatment.
I mean, a promise is a promise, Dante.
Yeah,
and we haven't even figured out if this old man is dead. So, don't you put all this weight on me?
It's true. We did get a lovely donation from RD Sin VCV. I believe that's your dad, right?
That's my dad.
Yeah, he. He donated $64, one lucky for each player, one unlucky for each, and one potion pouch for Tracy and James.
Ooh, awesome.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
There we go.
Thank you so much, Pops.
Now we can do it.
You may need them. You may need them. So there's a jingle up above you. Not that you'll have time to get to these before the initiative roll happens, but there's a jingle up above and two little pouches start to parachute down from the sky, landing near Dante and Milva. And when we get a chance to open those, we might do that.
If you survive.
But as I've said, it is now initiative.
What?
Right. Gotta roll initiative.
Oh,
well, that makes sense.
Oh.
Even if you're gonna run away, you gotta roll initiative.
No, what I rolled makes sense.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll tell you, I rolled a 17.
Yikes.
So where...
I'm dead!
Has anyone beaten a 17?
I rolled a 17 also.
I rolled a 19 in total.
Okay, so that's gonna be Dante first. And then Milva, and then me. What are we looking at over there?
I got a 14.
Okay. Yep, I'm last.
A 14 for Dark. And then little Miramith.
Right. If it seems like I'm not paying attention, I'm just building my other character.
Yeah.
It's valid. It's valid and an important aspect.
Seems reasonable.
Dante, this old dwarf, thuds to the ground near your feet And you see this tentacle rear back like it's getting ready to strike again. But you get to go first.
Oh, perfect.
There is a potion pouch at your feet, as well as one at Nova's feet.
Okay, Jared. Dante is going to move. He's going to forget about the pouch, because that's not the thing that matters. In his movement action, he is going to draw the Cure Light Wounds wand of Cure Light Wounds.
Okay.
And tap this old man while standing in front of him.
Okay. The you tap your wand on this man, and you feel the magic flow from the wand into the old man. However, still glancing at the old man, you can tell he is alive, but there is a glassy look over his face, and you can see tiny pinpricks of what can only be described as stars reflecting in his eyes. He makes no outward turn or adjustment.
Okay.
Nova. What do you do?
Does it cost an action to grab this bag and see what's inside, or should I?
It will cost at least your move.
I think that is fine, because where I probably don't want to get too closer at this point. So I'm going to see what's in the bag in case there's something.
You pick up this bag, flip open the drawstrings, and inside you find three potions. One labeled as Cure Light Wounds, one labeled as Bless, and one labeled as Levitate.
Okay. Well, writing this down. Cool. Okay. Well, with that, I think I'm going to try to strike at this giant tentacle above the dwarf. So I will pull out my longbow and try to attack it and see how we do. Oof. 11.
11's not gonna, oddly, surprisingly enough, 11 is gonna go far and wide across this. You're just so thrown off by the writhing and the sudden appearance of this gargantuan tentacle that you fire blindly.
Yeah.
And miss, sadly. But now it is the tentacle's turn.
Oh, great.
Whoa, hold on, pause. Jared does not get an extra lucky and unlucky. Those donations were for the players.
I'm a player.
No. I refuse to let you win.
Well, I'm not even going to use it here.
I
did the math.
$20 for two potion pouches, $24 for unluckies, and $20 for luckies. Sir.
All right, you went, okay.
Don't anger GM. Please.
Yeah, yeah. As the giant tentacle rears back, ready to strike in at the now blocked dwarf. So there is a little fat. Oh no, he ran away, right? Like
Benji's
out.
Yeah, by the
he's
tree.
He's where I dropped him.
Dante is definitely in the way of this tentacle that's going to. It's almost like a downward slap, coming towards you. You see the suction cups themselves separate, and you can see a little tiny mouth inside of it. And I'm going to use a lucky here.
I'm going to unlucky that.
Jared, the good news is you have another lucky and unlucky, because Crossbones just gave you what you were missing before.
Yes.
Crossbones is the best. I'm going to use a lucky.
I'm going to unlucky that.
All right.
How many of those do you have?
I had two.
So never mind. I'm not going to.
So this giant tentacle is going to come down and try and slap eat you.
Mm-hmm.
Is an 8 on the die. Does a 19 hit you?
19 is my armor class.
Okay, so yes, this maw of spiny teeth and suctioned goo comes down, just slaps you right on the chest, and you can feel your innards being kind of sucked into it. You are considered grappled.
As the suction cups go to touch Dante, you see it go right through him as he casts the instantaneous action, Windy Escape.
Well, how many times a day do you get that?
3.
All right. That's 2. But yep. You've used it. All right.
I know. I'm keeping track of my spells.
All right. Wow. What is Dark doing now?
Darek is feeling pretty grossed out. He's ew, gross. No, don't let it touch you. Oh, that's awful. Don't. Oh. Ugh. And he's going to load. So he's going to put knock an arrow, but which would be a normal arrow this time.
Right.
But he's not going to fire yet. Instead, he's going to whisper under his breath and say, oh, fine, I'll help, do the thing, whatever. And he's going to activate an item that he has to cause Mage Hand to appear and pull out his potion of cure light wounds and fly that towards Miramath.
Ooh. Okay.
And so rather than do any other action, he will say, fine, Miramath, just drink this and then can we go? It's super gross and I don't want to deal with tentacles. Tentacles are not cool. They are gross. And that's it. So there will be a potion sort of floating in front of Miramath.
Yeah, this potion kind of floats in your direction, Miramath. What do you do?
Is it? That's an action to drink the potion, right?
It is.
I think Miramath will do that, and then. So I'll drink the potion, which is a D8.
So 1D8 plus 3, I believe.
I imagine that Darek's like really trying for like fine control with Mage Hand, and he's like, okay, just tip your mouth back, and it'll just tip back and just stay right there. No, just bottom lip out just a little bit. Oh, you're shaking too much. Miramath, stop it.
I'm not moving.
Oh, fine, just grab it. You're the worst, Miramath.
All right. Do you want me here, Rady? Do you want to roll? It was your potion, or do you want me to roll?
You probably want to roll. I guess.
That's true. That's an 8 on the dice.
Yeah.
You get a whole 11 hit points back as this potion warms your innards like some hot chocolate on a cold day.
So that was my action. I'm going to use. I'm trying to think if I'm still holding any weapons. Because
when you go unconscious, I believe you drop your things.
So he will work. Can I use my movement? Like, are my things? Did I just collapse next to my things?
Yeah.
Could I use my movement to grab my shield and. Wait, let me say it right. Wakizashi blade?
Sure. You just grab the right next to you. You're not really moving far. I'll say yeah.
Cool. And then I'm guessing that would really be all I can do because that's movement.
That's move and an action. Yes.
Then I.
But you now have a shield in your arm.
But now I have a shield on my arm, and I will take my 6 seconds to also say, thank you, Darek. Get the dwarf out of here.
Gross. Why? He's old.
And you, not necessarily you, anyone, literally anyone, get the dwarf out of here.
I'm just not sure what the smell is from. It's either the dwarf or the tentacles, and honestly, I don't want to go near either, because it smells bad.
Well, that's fine. Milva, or Dante! This is over 6 seconds now, but...
Yeah, Dante.
I won't talk for the next 2 turns.
You've Windy stepped through this tentacle that looked beastly. What are you doing? Your party seems to want to run away.
I am going to try to pick up this old man and sprint as far away as I can in the direction of Benji.
Well, you can't sprint carrying a man, but I'll say you could get over to kind of where Darek is with him.
Okay.
Like you can get your 30-ish feet away.
And then I'm going to yell at Nyx and just, Nyx, grab him and get him away from this area. We will try to hold him off as long as we can.
Nyx isn't there.
Oh.
Nyx
hasn't been there in a while.
Oh boy.
Weren't you listening to the pre-story?
No, because that's metagaming.
He's not wrong.
Be honest. Did James know Nyx wasn't there?
Yeah. Okay. She ran to go tell them. And she's in love with the dwarf, and she feels bad about running. So yes, I was listening.
Just checking.
Nathan.
Dante, yes. James, I have one other thing you should listen to. Crossbones just gave another $12 to give two more unluckies for Jared.
I saw. So, it's really pissing me off, but so
enjoy,
it's cool.
Enjoy rolling.
Yeah.
Keep it up, Crossbones.
It's a fucking blast.
So you glance around for Nyx and you notice she's not there.
And that would be my full turn?
Yes.
Cool.
Your action to pick him up and your move to get him over there. Milva, you are still, you're kind of between, you're near Miramith, if I recall, closer than Darek is, because you ran up to engage the golem with your blade.
I did, yes. So Dante has made a good amount of distance from this thing with the dwarf, right?
I mean, it can still get there, but yeah, he's 30 feet away from this.
I'm gonna still try to distract it and then make my movement back a little bit. So I'm gonna try to attack it again and hopefully kind of avert the attention, but we'll see, because I've been striking out. Actually, let me, I'm debating using my lucky now on this. You know what? I think I'm going to, because I have been not rolling well the last two sessions on attack rolls. So we're gonna try.
Smurt.
Okay, there we go. A 16 plus 6. So I'm hoping that hits.
22. That will hit.
Or if that did not hit.
You hit it.
I would be scared if that didn't hit. All right, D8. I didn't pull out my D8 for my dice thing. That is 5.
Your arrow flies in towards this tentacle, and you manage to pierce almost. It's a clean through and through. You see the arrow exit on the other side, taking with it a chunk of, for lack of a better term, squid meat with it. You can also see that the moment the meat leaves the main appendage, strands of skin and muscle start to regrow and fill in area
disgusting.
That was.
We better move quickly.
Removed.
I just, as I see that, I just, let's get out of here. And then, yeah, I will use my movement to start slowly backing away.
Okay. That leaves this tentacle thing and really, only Miramith is the target here. Everyone else is kind of...
Oh god, I forgot about Miramith.
Kind of moved away.
Hi and bye, everyone.
Sorry, Miramith.
Hi and bye. Just tell the tale of how he killed 6 skeletons all at once. Just do that for me.
We'll see. We'll see how this goes.
Unlucky.
Oh, I can't cancel unluckies with unluckies. Hmm. But you should know that Crossbones donated $12 to give me an additional 2 more unluckies. So
Well, now, as the executive producer of the network, I do have to decline a donation that just came in, unfortunately. Came in for $24 from Dual Stone Rage for 4 unluckies for James.
Oh.
What?
Interesting.
Wait, James, are you trying to buy your own bonuses?
Hell yes, I am. I will spend $1,000 right now if I have to.
Oh my gosh. Wait.
All right. So you've unluckied this this tentacle slap. Gosh. This slap eat.
Uh-huh. With my one unlucky.
Woo! 10 is the low on the die.
Oh,
does
no.
a 21 hit you?
Yep.
Okay. You feel the instant simultaneous slap and kind of bury of these spined teethlet things, and you feel your energies being sapped into it.
As it goes to hit me, I use Dante's last thing where I'm the wind. I'm like a leaf on the wind. Is that what it's called?
Wild magic surges, and Dante is now standing in Miramith's. No.
I'll allow it.
You take. Ooh, that's a lot of damage. You're going to take 9 points of damage and give me a fortitude save.
Oh my. Okay. Just one second, sir.
Oh god.
Fortitude.
Yes.
Yikes.
I'm so sorry, Miramath.
How's a. Now, I should have called my lucky. You should have called that on that roll. How's a 12 do me?
It worked great for me.
Yeah.
you feel your energy sapped out of you and flowing into this tentacle thing. Your eyes start to glass over. The only thing you can see are little pinpricks of, for lack of a better term, stars. You other three, you see the tentacle flail, twitch, and then toss Miramath across the field as it rears back, ready to strike again.
All right, I'm going to be building that other character. You guys
going.
You're
unconscious
right,
for a little bit. So...
I'm unconscious?
You're unconscious for a little bit.
Oh, okay. But I still have hit points.
That's you still nice. Have hit points. You're not dead. You're just unconscious. Just cool, to cool. let you know.
Cool.
Darik.
So Darik's going through a little bit of mental and emotional exercises right now. Miramath has been with him since the beginning. Mm-hmm. And... while he knows that the mission is to save the old dwarf, he's definitely closer to Miramath, and Miramath was just thrown further away from danger. So to go save someone, it would actually be both beneficial selfishly and selflessly to go get Miramath. So Darik is going to go run over and try to start dragging Miramath away from danger. I don't know how far I can get him, if anywhere, but that is what Darik will begin doing.
Okay, yeah, you can get to him and kind of scoop him up this round.
Gotcha. And then just a logistical question. James, did you add your 4 unluckies to your document?
I added it.
Okay, yeah, I was okay. I didn't touch it.
Okay, well, we also had your father who just gave another lucky for Tracy, James, Adam, and Nathan, and another lucky for Tracy, James, Adam, and Nathan, making sure that we know exactly how that math shakes out. So I'm going to add those in.
Awesome.
And,
I love you, father.
We'll move on.
I got to call my dad. Hold on, guys. you can get to him and scoop him up. Miramath, roll a fortitude save.
I am going to use a lucky.
All right.
I'm going to call it at the beginning this time. Well, one of them is a 1.
Oh.
And the other one's a 5 plus my same 6 is 11.
Nice.
Those stars are shining bright above me.
You feel the paralytic taking hold. It doesn't have you completely yet, but you feel like it soon might. Also, now, in your mind's eye, you get a glimpse of a darkened and fiery realm with a winged serpent woman standing above a table. She's got long, flowing white hair. On the table, you can see 7 distinct points of light hovering over what you know to be a map of Tel Areth.
Well, that just doesn't seem great, Jared.
In fact, it's probably apocalyptic at times.
Mm. Now, really quick, can I? Because I forgot about my elvenness. Is this a?
Charm.
I guess is this a? Yeah, is this some?
This
sort
is
of...
not an enchantment. No.
Okay. Well, in that case, business as usual. Continue. Thank you for that information.
All right. Dante, you're over, you get over to Darik with the old man dwarf just in time for Darik to run back and scoop up Miramith. Milva is slowly making her way towards you. What do you do?
How far am I away from Benji?
Benji's probably about 15 feet away. You told him to kind of stay back.
I am going to call him and tell him to get in the papoose.
Okay.
Handle animal.
Just like a return to pouch type situation?
Yeah. Okay. That's a 12 on the die and a 5 for handle animal.
Oh, yeah. He gets up there. He Perfect. Scampers up your back and drops into the papoose. He's facing you this time instead of out.
Okay. So. Then I am going to pick up the dwarf. Was he still in my hands?
Yeah, I mean, he's kind of like draped over your shoulder, you know? Okay.
Perfect. And then I'm going to look at Milva and Darik and be like, we need to leave now. We do not have enough strength to be able to fight this creature. And he is... Yes, we need to leave. Oh, I'm looking the wrong way. Yes, we need to leave. And he's going to sprint another 30 feet into the forest.
Okay. All right. Milva. Dante is running away. It looks like Darik may have Miramith in hand. What are you doing?
I too am going to use all my movement, I guess, to begin running away. Does Darik look like he has Miramith, or maybe?
Yeah,
I
he looks
assist?
Like he can carry. Yeah.
Okay.
He's not trying to like power lift him or anything.
Okay.
But
then yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and make my way as far away as I can. Use all my movement.
Okay. You see, you guys are all out of range of this tentacle currently. You see it swing about and kind of reach back behind it and grab onto a portion of the tower and just rip down.
Oh boy.
Some masonry falls to the ground, and there's a small hole in the tower. At the same time, there is a blinding flash of light of crimson and purple and a plume of dark black smoke. As you feel the rush of wind and movement flowing out of the tower and into the surrounding wilds. Darik, you're holding Miramith.
Yep.
What are you doing?
Skedaddling.
All right, you drag Miramith away.
I'm gonna drag Miramith. I feel like Darik would not necessarily be thinking about following the rest of the group in terms of... Sorry, I should word this... I'm trying to word this correctly. So I don't know where I am on the battlefield, but what I'm saying is if the shortest distance to cover is not where they're headed, Darek will head to the closest spot where there is cover, and maybe that will actually help distract this thing from going after everybody if we sort of split slightly as we leave.
Okay. Yeah, you're not far from the tree line of this clearing where this field kind of opened up.
Okay.
So like 10, 15 feet, and you can kind of get into the dense underbrush.
That's probably there. About as far as I can get him anyways, because I'm not too strong. So
you're like, I don't have another point, but I'd say like 90 degrees from the road. Like if the road's running here that they're at, you're kind of up this way.
Okay. Yeah, so. I'm going to head towards the wooded area, the cover.
And Miramath, this is a very important one.
Mm-hmm.
Roll fortitude save.
You should use that lucky, Miramath.
I'm
going
to use that lucky. I'm also going to use my nice new Chessex dice that just seemed to be Miramath themed. These came in the dungeon crate that was Dragons and Things themed.
Dragons and Things dungeon crate.
Yeah. Nice. So we'll see how they do me. Well, you know what? They pushed the other dice where I needed it. So that's how they're helping right now. That's an 18 on the dice for my fortitude plus 6 is 24.
Okay. You start to kind of rouse yourself. The glossiness that has encased your eyes is starting to peel back. You do have a couple more images kind of floating in your mind. Mm-hmm. You see something that looks like a pale jellyfish-like creature floating in the air, two long eye stalks kind of extending from either side of its puckered mouth. You see it fluttering around actually what you would assume would be the city of Marist, one of the districts that you've seen.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Old Town, might be the docks, not quite sure. And you also see near the waterline in Marist a swollen cephalopod with 10 writhing tentacles and a hideously monstrous face with pale milky eyes on its bulbous body reaching up and dragging sailors under.
I'm just gonna note that I see a super evil squid attacking.
Yeah. Yeah. And that is what you see. You start to get feeling back in the extremities of your hands, of your arms and your limbs. Silent H says it could be a good squid.
Don't rule it out.
Just Dante. Just want some friends.
Are you going to go back and fight this creature, or are you essentially going to run away? Because if you run away, we can drop the initiative.
Yeah, I'm...
But if you're going back in...
No. Why would... No. I'm going to continue to run away.
You've made some choices before.
I have. But my goal was to bring this old man out of danger, and I have done that.
Okay. Well, then I will drop initiative currently. We are in free play. What do you do? You all kind of manage to get down the road, catch your breath. Dark, are you eventually going to make your way back to them?
Yeah.
Okay.
So am I coming to now?
Yeah, you by the time you and Dark are back with the others, you're conscious again.
Okay. So I kind of come to as he is carrying me, and I'm just kind of, I think I'm still probably, you know, leaning on Darek a little bit. If he hasn't like shrugged me off yet, but just that creature, I saw things when it hit me. I saw Merst under attack.
Yeah, It was a weird squid octopus tentacle thing. It was weird. We should go. We shouldn't be here. And I bet my microphone isn't working anymore.
No, it's not.
We can hear you.
You did great. Thank you, Darek.
Yeah. Whatever. Let's go. Stand up. You're heavy. You have a lot of armor on.
I do. I do. I apologize.
Jared, I want to pop my only potion of lesser restoration and pour it down the dwarf's mouth.
Oh, and the medicine. We have some of his medicine. Maybe we should give it to him.
It's going to take 10 minutes to be able to make that up right now.
Okay. You pop the fluid of this potion, and it runs. You start to pour it into his mouth, and it runs down into him, into his stomach. There is no outward change to the old dwarf man.
I'm still seeing the stars in his eyes?
Yes.
Fuck.
If he's going through what I did, I barely pulled myself away. And if he was hit more than I, for we did not find his weapon, it could be that he fought that thing long before we got there.
As you're standing there, there is a set of chimes that comes from above, and landing at your feet, Miramath, is a lovely pouch with a little name tag on it that says Brian Numinator.
Brian Numinator! Thank you so much!
It's really weird that all these potion pouches keep being addressed to weird people that we don't know. I've never heard of Brian. You're not Brian.
Oh, I left the pouch!
Oh no, Dante. Your pouch.
I also left my masterwork flail is laying on the ground there.
Oh no! Well, you can go back for it. Send Dante back for it.
Send Benji. Fetch.
Send Benji.
I'll say Benji because the viewers paid for it. I'll say Benji grabbed the pouch.
Oh, okay.
And he's just noshing on it. He's just like chewing.
Not the flail.
Oh, not the flail.
Not the flail.
Oh, poor Miramath.
Benji, I'm going to get you a nice thigh when we get back to the city.
Whoa.
I open the pouch, Jared.
There's a potion of Cure Light Wounds, a potion of Bless, and a potion of Dark Vision. Bless you.
Ooh. And what does mine contain?
Yours has a potion of Cure Light Wounds.
Ooh.
A potion of Bless.
Oh, well then.
And a potion of Dark Whispers.
Dark Whispers? Whispers. What is that? What are Dark Whispers?
Dark Whispers.
They're like light whispers, but darker.
But different, yes.
It's just a lower octave of whispering.
You communicate through the shadows of one or more targets within range. The shadows have no physical presence and don't move or animate. Instead, your words emerge from the shadow as a clear whisper. The targets can make conversation with the shadow, but must speak aloud.
Interesting.
Voices emerge from your own shadow only when they attend to speak to the shadow.
Wow. I could use that to really... Oh, wait, no. I could just use it to mess with James. I can't use it to mess with Artemis.
I did want to take a quick 10 so I can make his medicine. And even though he's not responding, I want to get him down.
You kind of pull off into like a little area now that you're sure you're not being pursued, and you start to brew his tea medicine, his stopgap medicine, and you get it. Give me a medicine check or heal check rather, or if you have any kind of craft alchemy, that'll work too.
I do not, but I have a really good heal. That's a dirty 20.
Okay, yeah, you're familiar with healing teas and potions. You brew it up nicely. You feed it to him, or you pour it down his gullet. It seems to be, he seems to take it. He doesn't. His appearance doesn't change, but you felt rest assured that you got some of the potion into him, or some of the medicine into him.
Miamath, how close is your church or your place of worship? I fear we need to get him some healing that I'm unable to do.
Would I have? Because I know I recently went to my temple, but I don't know, is there one in town for me?
So yeah, right. So you're about a day and a half out from the city right now. You know, in the Seclum Ward, that there are temples to almost every deity. That is a close one. That's not the same temple that you went to, but right. They do have a temple there. It would be the
best thing.
Yeah. They also have all the other, like, they have one that's focused just to the Numen Prime, like all of the primary deities. So, like, if you want holy kind of information, it's in that ward.
At best, it seems we are, because of that dimension we went to, a day and a half out of town. That will be the closest place.
We don't have that time. Is there any way we can find that door again into the steel bear and just kind of jump our way through?
We can try to retrace our steps, but I don't know.
That door may not be there much longer, if anything. We can try.
It seems like a one-way kind of thing, but we can try.
They said it changes by the day. We should... And you see, like, AM start to hyperventilate a little bit. He's like, we should have time. There's time. We have to get him there. Can I do a survival check to see?
Yeah, if you want to try and like figure out kind of where it was in position to you. Yeah, absolutely, survival check.
Yeah, I'm gonna use a lucky on this because I really need it. Yeah, I'm glad I did that. That's a 19 on the die for a 29.
Yeah, you can find that kind of burnt down, beat down shack that you came out of. It takes about 2 hours to locate, but you find it.
I someone opened the door. I have him in my arms. I need help.
I'll help Dante out, try to open the door and see if we can go back
in. I was probably helping Carrie.
Okay, you open the door and it opens to a warm and inviting common room that you've seen before, that you know as the Seely Old Bear.
All right, that's good. Good news.
Okay. I can't even talk to the people in here as much as I want to. I'm going to immediately go to the back door, and before I open it, I'm going to think about the... old folks home. Like, that is going to be the
I
only
thought thing. He'd think about the day spa.
Yeah.
Ozia.
the elderly home for adventurers. I'm going to beg Milva to open the door for me.
Yeah, I'll help him out.
What's Milva thinking about?
Rain drops on roses, whiskers on kittens.
You know, I would be thinking about this old man too. Because I'm pretty concerned. I'm unfortunately not thinking about a day spa. So I would also have the old man on my mind and the old man home or the old people home.
Yeah,
the old home for elderly.
Yeah. Yeah.
For whatever you for call it.
Orderlies.
Okay. You open the door and it opens up to, I can't find my note here.
When it opens up, I go, did no one think of a hospital?
Well, for a second, yeah, I was thinking
we could have gone right to the church.
To the church, but...
Well, I don't understand. Why did we not think of a hospital?
Dante not smart. He's just thinking of the only place that would knows how to deal with the elderly. And
that's what I was thinking too.
Dante,
yeah, a hospital would also do that.
I love that response. Dante, not smart. you sure enough step into the bush area, the bushy area that you went into at the Aged Bramble Estates. In the courtyard, it is evening now, getting on nighttimey. But you are back in this courtyard.
You guys will see Dante sprint away from you guys and barge into the home and just scream for, like, anyone help? I need help immediately. Anyone that can, come, help!
Dante sprinted away and Miramath was helping him. So did you take the dwarf with you? Am I being dragged? Or did you, like, drop him and just go running for help?
No, I've been carrying the dwarf the whole time.
I said I helped.
Oh,
I said it, James. It's truth.
I didn't hear you. But you weren't helping in the forest when I was carrying him, so I don't need your help now.
I was unconscious in the forest, James. We were traveling 2 hours. He was heavily armored. You didn't get tired?
Never.
Wow. You run in and you're like, help, help. And sure enough, one of the doctors in there comes up and is like, oh, what? You found him. Good job. Good job. What? What? He like kind of slaps him on the face a little bit. What's wrong with him?
Don't slap him. He's been poisoned. Someone get a healer. Or something. I don't have the capability to heal him at this moment.
I'm a doctor.
A pool man.
What? We have to figure. What happened to him? We can't just go pumping him with anti-venoms.
He was attacked by this tentacle creature inside the Seven Star Tower.
It is something of the mind. Something has taken his mind to another place.
You say, at the words inside the tower, the doctor kind of steps back.
No, you can't be here. Get him out. You can't be. I have not seen you.
And he turns and runs deeper into
the
room.
What?
What are you?
What
Captain! Captain!
Hey, everybody. Remember how you're not supposed to go on the tower or the penalty is death?
He's part of the order. He's allowed in the tower.
Well, I don't think so, because he wasn't in the order anymore. And also, now you just said we got him out of the tower, so the inference is that we were in the tower. And so I don't think you're going to make any friends this way. But you know what? Whatever. Let's do it. Day spa.
He was okay. Well, side note, he was able to get into the tower, so obviously he still has some ability and is still part of the order. Yes, side my note. Wording.
Side note, pretty sure you're wrong. Side note.
My wording was probably incorrect because it did make it seem like we were inside the tower as well, but I don't care. I am just trying to get this old man
help. Oh, yeah, no, I don't blame anybody. I'm just saying I think that's what's happening. Dark's just trying to sarcastically be helpful.
Ah.
Maybe we should take him somewhere else then.
A church may not turn us away, or if we go back to our own headquarters where his relative is our captain.
That's also true.
Fine, let's... The church is probably our best option. I don't see another way. Miramath, just show us the way, please.
We should probably try to get more of his medication so we can administer it if need be. I'll see if I can try to get some.
Yes, please, Milva, and catch up with us soon.
Yes, we'll do.
I'm going to look to Miramath and ask him to lead the way.
And
I'm going to
go for it.
Nothing. I'm going to look at Miramath and say, Miramath, if you're leading the way, why don't we go back into the bear place? Because that's the closest place. And then just think about where you want to go.
That could work. That's actually a very good idea, Darek.
It's less walking.
We're definitely gonna lose Milva.
How far is the temple from the?
I mean, the district. It's a couple miles. I mean, it's okay, within the
that's
city.
Fine. Like,
unless Miramet, yeah, unless Miramet thinks of the finest hospital in all the land.
Yeah,
which happens to be located three countries away.
Then yeah, forget it. You guys are gone.
Yes, Milva, just think of the church quarter when you go to the bear place.
And we just start going.
Go to the bear place. Oh yes. Yeah.
Look, we've only got so much time.
Yeah, don't think about the St. Mary's of Tentacle. Just go. You gotta just go to the closest hospital.
Nope. I go into the bear place. I get to the other side of the door. I'm guessing with Darek and Dante. And then I start thinking about the church street.
As you're standing at the front door, Rowan looks up. He's like, this is not some sort of boat station or throughway.
He's dying, man.
Yeah, I can see it, which is why I'm allowing it this time. But this cannot become a habit.
Well, I'm just surprised we found you multiple times. I kind of figured I didn't expect it to be a habit.
We've got multiple doorways and multiple anchors. We'll see.
I'm going to reach in my pocket and chuck 9 gold pieces at him and go, I'm sorry, this is the only option we have.
Pocket sand.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
You open the door. That's fine. You open the door and it opens onto the Seclamord.
As we walk through the door, I just say, by the way, our female friend is going to try this too. Thanks, bye.
That's what the gold is for.
I was probably just going to
also, I'll be back for the day spa.
The Seclum Ward of Marist gleams with light. Highly polished limestone and quartz line the streets, the buildings, and the fountains. The walkways are spotted with large blooming willows that provide shaded areas to sit, meditate, and study. All of Mare's temples are here in the Seclum. Smaller temples and shrines to the minor and less worshipped deities are sprinkled about the district. All roads lead to the chancel, the largest temple in the district and one dedicated to the Numen Prime gods, Ordu, Tisrael, Nadrian, Acker, Aoka, and the Unrenowned. Directly across from the entrance of the chancel stands the quorum headquarters for the Order of the Protectorate.
Actually, that one seems like a really good place to go.
No.
He was a part of the Protectorate. He was hurt by something that attacked the Protectorate.
Yes, but as that doctor clearly got scared after hearing that he went into the tower. I'm not going to risk his own order killing him. We get healing here, Miramal.
Well, here is like pick a temple, any temple. I'm just saying that was one of the options.
If we're voting, I'll vote for that one. 2 out of 3, we win.
I am going to turn to the closest temple and ignore them and bring the dwarven with me.
How long you been carrying this dwarf?
Just by yourself,
as long as I need to.
Like 8 hours.
Is this over the shoulder or is this a cradle?
He is also in the papoose. No.
It's got
so you have
like
Benji on you and you're carrying
I will take
the
exhausted condition after this. I do not care. I am
taking
care of
this. Can you take the exhausted condition now, though?
That's fine.
It was 2 hours.
I will take the exhausted condition.
But if you take it now, then I don't think you can carry him now. So I think we're going to take him to the other. James, I'm literally just messing with you.
Going to drag him in.
What you got to do?
And James is gonna
afterwards kill my own teammates.
James is about to donate so much money so that his character can kill us.
I do not care how much debt I put on myself right now. I will destroy everyone except Milva.
So you have a choice. You can basically go to the largest temple or any of the smaller ones. They also have the gods themselves each have individual temples as well as the primary, the large one.
Is there a temple of Matterin?
Matterin?
The Matterhorn.
The druid god? The goddess?
Nadarin? Yeah.
Nadarin.
Yeah. Yeah, she's got her own kind of temple over in the corner.
Yeah, I would go to a temple of a god that I'm most comfortable with.
Okay. You walk in to the temple. It's really more of a set of those willows that have woven together to form kind of a barrier around. Everything is very, very simple and clean and wooden. You walk in and a young halfling walks up.
Well, welcome. Oh my, what's the problem here?
Please, our friend has been attacked by this tentacle creature. We think it's something of the mind and he needs help. I don't have the healing to be able to provide him.
Well, let's bring him this way.
And I don't care how much it costs, just help him.
He leads you into a back room.
He's like, I'll run and fetch the priestess. Please place him there on the bed.
And he runs out of the room. A few moments later, the acolyte comes back, and there is a very tall, very old woman that walks in. She's like, oh dear, what has happened? This is no good. And she walks over to him and starts kind of examining him.
What? How did he come by these wounds?
We were attacked in the woods by a black tentacle creature. It did something to his mind. As you can see, his eyes are covered in stars.
That seems odd. Let me.
She throws some kind of incenses around, and she prays. And after a couple moments, she comes up.
It's like, this is beyond me alone. I cannot even determine what has caused this. Are you aware?
And she lifts up his tunic, and you can see that there's just like a large black and purple indent where one of the suckers must have hit.
It's like, this is powerful magics. I will continue to consult the books and my friends, but this is beyond me right now. You're free to leave him here, and we will do our best to care for him.
No, where can I go to get help? The help I need. I came to you as a druid in hopes that you could help him, and you're not doing anything.
One can only do what they can do.
Point me at a temple whose god actually cares about the people.
Dante.
Well, watch yourself, druid. You are one of us, but I can see to it that you're not for long.
Dante, step outside.
I understand emotions are high, but you must understand, this is godly level magics. This is not for mortals to deal with alone.
She goes back to inspecting the wound, and like there's a piece of like necrotic flesh that she kind of picks up, and she does the little spits it out. She goes over
science.
She goes over to a kind of an alchemist's table and mixes some herbs together and creates a poultice. She comes back and applies it.
It's like, I've got to commune and speak with others for guidance on how to further heal this.
If I may, I was struck by the same creature. It took all that I had. My mind had to be at its strongest, so Again, as much as it is a physical wound, it is one of the mind. If any focus can be put there, I would encourage it.
You, lift your shirt.
Hello, I'm Miramath, by the way.
No time for pleasantries. Get nude. No.
you also have a large ring with purple and slightly necrotic flesh around where this maul kind of dug into you. It is not enough. It's not causing you pain, and it looks like it would heal.
There's like a weird woven shape to it where my chainmail shirt was, of just like some of the sucker got there, and then like there was the chain like pressing.
Were you behind a fence when it got you?
No, do you see my armor?
A weird sunburn.
She's like, oh, let me mix some of this for you, and she mixes some of the poultice as well for you to apply the salve. I guess it would become at this point.
Thank you. A bit of Bengay
for the
yes, joints. Exactly. And then she's like, "Yes, you can leave him here, or you can take him elsewhere." But I mean, I cannot do anything alone. I will reach out to others of my order and others of the healing peoples and see what we can. See what we can do.
If the Temple of Amun-Brar can be of any help, just let them know that Miramath Berior of the Woodland Realm sent you.
Very well. I will do what I can, and I will send word once we know. Maybe Ordu knows something. I will go to his priests and speak. Speak to them directly. Leave him with me. He will be safe here. I will put young Willis here on his room to watch over him constantly. The halfling kind of stands up a little bit taller. It's like, I'll do my best.
I don't mean to be a bother, but are there any spa facilities on site?
Do you have just a really steamy room?
We do have the hot springs.
Oh, those sound nice. Is there an exfoliation routine that goes with that?
I mean, I guess you could rub yourself against a rock.
Okay, so no proper facilities. Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Great. Dante was right. This is a little backwater. Okay.
It's in the middle of town. It's on Church Street. The whole town's
a little backwater.
Yeah, Dante is outside on his hands and knees weeping because he feels like he can't do enough. And if you start to walk up to him, you can hear him under his breath of like, my God can't do anything. What's the point of even trusting in her? Why am I here if I can't even bring a child's promise? Why do I put so much work and effort into saving this town if I can't even help those that are weak? And he punches the ground, and he just kind of stays there sobbing.
Roll to hit.
Hey there, big guy. You want to get a soda?
Mark, all you care about,
Dante.
All you care about is the spa. Don't give me that. And he
No. That's not fair. That's not all I care about. All right. Sometimes there are nice fabrics. There are great places to eat. I really care about fashion and looking good as well. And I think it's important to practice good personal hygiene. In the meantime,
he cares for others.
Dante, maybe we could get you some lunch. Would you want to come for some lunch? We'd go get some lunch.
I don't deserve lunch, Darik. I'm weak.
Everyone deserves lunch.
Yeah, even weak people deserve lunch.
Deserve to be here. And you see Benji gets out of his pouch, and he starts to lick the tears off of his face.
Because it's... I don't have anyone. I just have Benji. And the people I'm surrounded by, and I can't even protect those. What am I supposed to do? Why was I sent here to this group if I can't even protect the ones I was told to protect?
Who were you told to protect?
We are sent to protect this town, and he is one of them.
I didn't know if there was like a bigger thing.
I promised a young girl that I would get her grandfather back without harm, and I can't even go to her now. I can't even look her in the eyes and tell her that he's okay.
Dante, listen to me. Whatever that was is beyond all of us. Possibly anyone in our regime. None could have done more than what we did. This is otherworldly. What we did there, we spared him. He has a chance. Had we not shown up, had Nick still been asleep, she too may have been hurt. But we got him out of there. Did you see me stand and fight? I fell twice. I could not any longer. The only option was to flee for our safety and our lives. Sometimes the best choice is to turn, that we may grow stronger and fight another day.
And you see Dante really taking those words. And he stands up and he goes,
I don't know, Mehmet. I don't know if my God has betrayed me or if I just don't have enough faith. But I can't stand by and continue to let people fall.
You know, Dante, maybe you just don't have enough patience because I don't know if you know this, but promises don't usually have a time limit. So, I mean, you brought the dwarf back, so that's part one of your mission, and now just got to get him healthy. And so you dropped him off before he's going to get healthy. And so if those two things happen, then your promise gets fulfilled anyway. So I don't really know what you're so worried about with your time frame. Was there a timer on it that I missed?
And when you say that, the realization kind of comes over his face, and he immediately grabs Darek and digs his head into his shoulder and cries.
Okay.
Just let it happen, man. Oh, he needs it.
Yeah,
he
maybe needs just... it. And Darek's like, look, like eyes wide, like looking at Mirmet.
Give me a tissue. Do you want to use the scarf you had made?
Oh, that's wonderful. It's beautiful.
Oh, no, okay. I mean, wait, I don't have much. I just...
No, oh, no, don't. Okay, yeah, like, no, it's fine.
Snot is coming down his nose.
No, it's fine.
I pick up the back of... I, like, grab the back of Dante. I grab the back of Dante's cloak, and I kind of pull it up over his own shoulder and, okay, like, hand it to him.
I'm like, oh, yeah, okay, yep, mm-hmm, no, just dry those tears and the horrible snot and gross saliva. Okay, yeah, no, just get all that. Yeah, just let it all... You got it. Okay.
Good. I couldn't ask for a better group of people to be with, and I'm sorry that I'm weak, and I will do everything I can to be strong, to protect you and the people of this city.
Yes. Well, we are thankful for you, Dante. I think I speak for myself, for Darek, for Milva. Oh, shoot. Do you think she heard the whole thing about go to the church street? I hope there's not another church street. Like an actual...
What if she thinks about a church street in a different town?
That could be an issue. That innkeeper's not going to be happy if she goes that
way. Because I don't know if she's ever been to this church street in this town.
A few moments later, Milva runs up out of breath. The door did not open to the silly old bear for her.
I gave him 9 gold.
She had to run through the city. She's, okay, I'm here, guys. I'm
5 here. Miles to get here.
Whew. It's 5. Oh, we misjudged that one. You know, it's faster flying. I think I went crow's distance.
It's all right. I'm here. I have some medicine. It's all good. Is everything all right? And I see like a crying Dante. And...
Oh yeah, it's ugly.
Yeah, Dark's still trying to like every time Dante looks at him, he stops. But like every time Dante stops looking at him, he's like trying to like clear up. Like stop. No, that's gotta come out. It's gotta come out.
You do have an absence of an old dwarf though.
So somebody mentioned lunch, and I think that's a really great idea. So maybe we could go get some lunch and just sort of mull over what the next steps in our plan are and when we have time to budget out for a spa day. Or just a treatment, just a four-hour sesh. Mm. That's fine, too.
Perhaps we should get lunch back at HQ and report back to what happened with the dwarf.
We can definitely, why don't we bring lunch back there? Because I don't know about you, Milva, but I have had enough of that cooking. And I know of a couple good places on the way. So, you know what? I'll lead everybody. Just follow my lead. We'll get back to HQ. Just pick something up quick. Just something quick.
To-go order.
Yes, I think that's fine. Maybe we should drop off the medicine, though, with the druid.
Yes, that is...
The druid temple's the one we're here. I'll go in with Milva.
I'm pretty sure we're just outside of it, so yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
As Dante still just weeps on your shoulder, I'm just like...
No, not on my shoulder anymore. Nope. Got him sitting down. He's sitting at least. I mean, I'm pretty sure he's just clutching my leg, you know, now and just whatever, but it's like, no, come on. Okay, yeah, fine. Yeah.
You Miramath and Milva walk into this temple, and you go back to the room where they left the, and there's this little halfling guy standing out front. He's like, "You can come in. I don't know you."
She's Hi. With me, friend.
I still don't know her. She no entry. The lady said none.
Oh wow. Sorry. I won't be long here. I just have to drop off this tea, this medicine, if you could please administer it to our unconscious dwarven friend, I think they said every few hours or so, that would be really great. He needs it. It's very important.
I'll pass it to the lady. She'll make the decision.
Please, it's urgent. We need to make sure this is imperative that he receives this.
I mean, she's the healer. She'll do it.
Okay. Just making sure.
She'll just make sure it's not poison first.
Don't
trust you.
I look over to Miramath. Do I look untrustworthy?
No, it's not you. I think he's just very committed to his work.
He slips inside. In the door, and the door closes behind him.
We'll be on our way then. I'm very offended as I walk out.
Understand. You guys gather in the courtyard and get ready to go get some. It's closer to dinner, but yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes it a pretty good time for us to probably go to our mid-show break.
Ooh.
Before we go to our mid-show break, I want to thank Brian Numinator, who gave me the re-roll.
Oh, no.
Brian Numinator.
Why? Congratulations.
Nice. There's so many better choices like me.
No. And before we go to mid-show, I wanted to do one more thing, Jared. Sorry to take away fire, but there we go. This Sunday, everybody, just so you know, we're giving away some Skittermanders on our Gen Con stream. It's on Gen Con main stage.
Oh.
Four Skittermanders are being given away. Color choices will be up to Paizo. Whatever they send out is what's going to be happening. That's at 1 p.m. Pacific on Gen Con main stage. So definitely check that out, and that's this Sunday. Okay, now it's time for mid-show break.
They've got dice pouches in their backs.
Yeah, those are dice pouch Skittermanders.
I want
what?
They're super cute. Soup's cute.
Soup's
okay,
cute.
Okay, goodbye.
Go to break. Bye.
Bye-bye.
inside of there.
Inside of the skeleton?
Inside of, like, where the skeleton bones crumbled.
You see
what appears to be a tiny skittering creature that looks like maybe an insect made of fish bones, and it's got a head full of glowing red eyes.
I'm going to pounce on it, like when a hawk dives down on prey.
But first, we're here.
I didn't know we were still in combat.
Okay, yeah, we're cool. Still in addition.
Got it.
So to be clear, I hit it with my trident. It crumbles into dust. I notice something. There's something here, guys.
What? Where?
Where the trident is pointed.
It's essentially right in the pelvical bone.
It's a dick insect.
Okay, I'll take a stab at it. I mean, if I haven't seen it, do I have to, like, attack with a disadvantage or something?
No, just roll to hit.
Okay. Four.
Four is not gonna do it. But you, to be fair, you were like, you just pointed this thing out. I don't know where it is. You're just like, where? The thing?
Yeah.
And you just like hit like the arm. And he's like, no, I said the pelvis. And you're like, I don't know what the pelvis is.
Don't you know where a dick is?
Oh, I know what a pelvis is.
Do you?
Now, Keelan, it's your turn.
I'd like to pounce on it.
Okay. Are you gonna just try
I'm gonna try to put my hands over it.
So you're gonna essentially try to grab it.
Yes.
Okay. So give me a CMB, a combat maneuver check.
14.
Okay. So you beat his defense. You pounce on it with your raven, human, weird feet. You can encompass it, and it's inside there now. And then while it's in there, I guess it's going to...
So can I tell if this thing is a dead thing or if it's...
Well, give me a knowledge religion check.
92.
Say 92?
19.
You saw the ladies secrets of the universe.
For the first time in D&D history.
A level 192 knowledge history.
It is not undead. It is squirming around in there and is going to try to bite you on your bird feet.
Okay.
Uh-oh, I'm going to get some damage. I might kill you, maybe. No. It is going to be a 26 to
okay.
bite you. Sorry.
That
Sorry,
hits.
A 22.
Yeah, that hits.
To bite you. You're going to take like 1 point of bite damage, but sadly, you are going to take 6 points of acid damage.
Oh, no.
As you feel the liquid from this creature's maw start
to... I am very blooded.
eat into your bird feet.
Yeah, I'm going to immediately let go and go into a corner and just...
You can let go. Yeah. And that's it at this point.
I can't move?
That was his
With
initiative.
One hit point left. No,
you can't
I don't
move
think
on
you
your turn?
Move.
Well, it's not her turn anymore.
Oh, it
you
attacked.
His turn.
Got it.
Sai, you hear a bird yelp, I assume?
Abe, you don't kill this thing, I swear to God.
I look over, I have that heavy mace in my hand, and I just go,
oh!
And I smash it.
Now you gotta be very careful, because her feet are like right there.
Jared, is it the accent? You're trying to kill me off. It's the accent, isn't it?
Hold on,
welcome back, y'all. I'm seeing some hate coming at me for the. I can assume it's the unsatisfying videos that was in the mid show there. Someone specifically requested it, so I put it in there.
I bet I know who requested it.
Yeah, and I haven't even seen his name in here.
A villain.
Was it Ben Birch? Because he's always the worst.
He is the worst. But Crossbow's like, that's not how you cut the cake. It's the best. Penguin Witch Doctor asked if I got more plants. I did. I got a bunch more leafy boys. I'm becoming a plant epidemic person. So we'll see.
Hey, but, I got a donation. James's dad loves me too. He doesn't want me to feel left out, so he's given me a bag of potions because I'm obviously traumatized about not being able to go to the spa.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Well, that
thank you so much, Bob.
That's great.
If I'd have known that, I'd just let you go to the spa.
Did we point out the amazing gifted subs
from Cadence?
No, we missed that.
Cadence
gifted 3 subs.
Thank you so much, Cade.
Thank you, Cade. That is helping us on our goal.
Thank you very much.
Quest to 400.
400.
Quest to 400. Quest to 400.
Man, they really did not like that mid-show video. Comparing it to my newfound deep fake GIF postings.
Yeah, well, at least they don't compare it to this show. You know what I mean? That's like true. if they were like, oh man, this show is the, you know,
it's true.
Comparable mm-hmm. to that, then we'd know.
Yeah.
We are.
I didn't see the little bar. Sorry.
Well, now you do.
Oh, I gotta kill this fly. Hang on.
Crossbones. Said, just want to take a moment and say, James, a fantastic job role-playing that. Thank you. I got a little bit emotional for realsies, so that definitely helped the character.
Going to fly. Sorry, everybody.
I got so drawn into it, James, that I forgot that Milva wasn't with you.
Yeah. Same. I know. Same. I wasn't.
Well, I apologize for that, Tracy.
I wasn't just purposely being silent while Dante was spilling all of his emotions there. I just didn't happen to be there.
That's good, because now I get things to build on when I'm writing the next episodes.
It's Lucas Martinez pointed out that we did not check for pudding in the kitchen.
Oh. The pudding.
That would have saved the
drive. That would have saved him.
Have we left from outside of there?
You're kind of walking, you're like in a group getting ready to walk and get food, which when we get back, we'll actually like teleport to the headquarters.
Okay, well, quick thing, I'm going to stop them, run back, and then take out my last boysenberry pudding that I had been saving for him, and I'm going to put it next to his table.
So in all the battle... In all the carrying of a dwarf for 2 hours, that pudding film just held it in place.
Pulls it out of his pocket like it's kind of like
it was in the papoose.
They'll like purify it. I'm sure.
I did a purify when I first got them.
So, well, it's not like indefinite.
Well, fine. Then I purify it again before I put it on.
You took pudding into the rainforest.
Yeah. Like, just let me have this, Jared.
Hey, James, you did just get a wonderful comment from DJ Ayers saying you are the best, hands down.
Hands down.
Hands down, everyone.
Put your hands down, Nathan. DJ hands down.
DJ Ayers. Hands down.
That's a true buddy right there.
No, it was very good. I loved it. It was a good moment.
It was.
I'm going to get some good gifts out of it. So,
of me crying in real life?
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you going to put that on deep fake?
Absolutely. Yeah, it's going to be, you're going to go for all the, like the crying film moments, and then it's just going to be James's face.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Then so Jared, your plan. What potion did I get?
What potion? Oh, yeah. Well, you know you got to cure light wounds.
You know
it. And you know you got a bless.
You know it.
But you also lift this one up, and there is a potion in there labeled Slipstream. Which allows you to create a low cresting wave of water that carries the target along the surface, or I guess you in this case, across the water or the ground. While moving across level ground, your speed increases by 10. If going downhill, increases by 20. So it's like a potion of moving quick. And it's going to last for 30 minutes.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a long-lasting potion.
That's a good one.
Potion of Slipstream.
Slipstream, yeah.
Interesting.
And it allows me to walk on water or travel on water?
It carries you along. It's like a little wave forms behind you, and you're like riding on the top crest of it. So you're kind of surfing along without a board.
That's cool.
It's interesting, and I've not seen it, which is why I picked it.
How long does that dark vision potion last, Jared?
Dark vision potion?
A potion of dark vision. Sorry, let me correct that.
3 hours.
Ooh.
Lucas says, I'm going to put your face on the ugly Dawson's Creek.
Crying gif.
Yes.
It's going to be that, and it's going to be Doctor Who crying in the rain.
James Vanderchu.
I see what you did there. All right. You adventurers, we're going to go back to the squad house, I believe, and make a plan. Is that what I recall as
the we were going to get lunch and go to the squad.
Yeah. You get lunch. You go to the Fruit King. He's got amazing fruit beverages and fruit kebabs.
Look, while we do get a smoothie from the Fruit King, that's not the only place we go, all right? There's other places, little holes in the wall that I know about.
Well, you go there and you get your food and you come back to the squad house. You are alone in the squad house. Well, the attendant is still there, but Brenna is not there. The horses are gone. So
they must have gone on a patrol of some sort. You know, I will say, as I fought to regain myself, I saw these images. Some sort of winged serpent at a table with 7 points of light over a map of Terra Lith. There was a jellyfish-like creature floating in the air. It was floating around Merst. And at the waterline, there was this super evil squid thing attacking the sailors on the ships. I do not know if these were things to come or if these are things. Could these things be happening at this very moment?
Darek has like a big bite and he's like, did anybody look outside? Did you hear anything? I didn't see anybody running and screaming.
So I don't think anybody's really getting attacked by a squid right now.
It could be something yet to come. That is a good point. But I don't know, maybe it's some sort of sign of something. I'm not quite sure. Perhaps there's somebody we can talk to about these visions that might know more. Maybe the Order would know more.
It's possible, yes.
I know that it's forbidden that we're supposed to be. We didn't go in the tower. It's impossible for us to go in. But these visions had something to do with what was in that tower.
Perhaps if we told the Protectorate?
Yes.
I'm trying to remember, and we didn't go in the tower. That much I do remember, but
we did not.
I'm pretty sure that Dante may be marked for death because he touched the door, and I'm pretty sure that the disembodied voice said that if you touch the door, the penalty is death, or he chose death. Something about death. I feel like death was definitely mentioned. Dante, you may be in trouble on that one. I don't mean to elicit some type of emotional response from you again, but you may be in trouble on that.
It doesn't matter anymore. Let them come. And you see Dante just kind of sulk back down. And he hasn't touched his food. He's not very hungry. And he just kind of keeps looking outside in the hopes that for some reason he'll see that old man walking healthy.
I kind of like lowly whisper to the other two. Is he all right?
No. Yeah, he's just doing his Phil Collins thing where he doesn't care anymore. It's a relevant joke for all the Twitch fans out there.
Yes. I too knew Philip. The man does not care.
Anymore.
After that battle where he could feel it coming in the air that evening. But no one would listen.
This is what we'd become. So Melva has an idea on the table to tell the protectorate.
Yes.
Dante is concerned about the old man and wants to see about getting him healed. Whatever he can do, but that's kind of a dead end currently.
We could go get my flail. There's things to do. I know it's not the most important thing, but let's just keep it on the list.
I feel like we should also wait for Captain Brynna to come back. Yes, but
I'm surprised. Where would she be?
I don't know.
Maybe she didn't get word that we were back yet. Or maybe she went to the aged place because we went there with the old, with the dwarf.
Milva, you did not see the dwarf's son at the establishment while you looked for the medicine, did you?
Don't think I did, no.
No, you didn't really go looking for him, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you'll hear Dante pipe up when he hears you say that and go, I called for him, I screamed his name, and he never appeared, and we didn't have time, so I left.
The last time you remember seeing Brynna was right before she sent you in.
She was off somewhere.
Aged Brambles, and then she said she had to go to the Potentate's keep to investigate something.
Oh, right.
Well, it might be some time till she gets back, then. I still suggest perhaps going to the Protectorate, but...
Well, Milva, you do have a point, because if they are going to try to come kill Dante, we should probably know about it. And rather than just being sitting around and being surprised, we could just go there and face it head on.
I do think we should do that. I think maybe after we see what we garner from there, perhaps we could talk to Kirafind and see if there is any whisperings on the underground of anything matching the descriptions of what I saw in these visions.
It is going on evening time as well, so let that factor into...
Ah, yes. Yeah, I think maybe we have time for one of these.
Yeah, Dante's gonna stand up, and he's like, I'm tired. I'm going to bed. Good night, everyone. He's gonna walk to the stables.
You go to your stall. The horses are currently out, but...
All of them?
Yeah.
God damn it, Jared! I wanted a moment with the horse!
Crash and his team are doing things.
Whatever.
They need horses.
Yeah, I'm gonna curl up with Benji and cast Speak with Animal on him.
Wow.
You know his accent, Jared.
I forget it, I'll be honest.
It's a Cockney accent.
Oh, right. What you want then?
I'm sorry for keeping you to the side, Benji. I was just more worried that I wouldn't be able to save you.
Boy, that thing's terrifying, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I ain't messing with that. I got to like your face, though.
Yeah. I'm glad you're still here, buddy. And, I don't know what we're gonna do, but I just can't seem to trust our god anymore. She doesn't seem to be there when we need her.
It's just one bad day. There's always more flies tomorrow, more bugs, more sun,
more thighs.
More thighs.
I've got quite a taste for human flesh now.
I know, but we gotta keep it between you and me, because as far as I'm concerned, they do not like having you eat people's thighs. I'm okay with it. Don't worry. If we're in combat and you, like, snag a thigh, I'm not gonna say no. But, you know, we just have to keep it on the DL if we can.
Yeah, right. Don't go talking about eating people.
Yeah, perfect.
That's good advice.
And Dante is going to do his little dance with Benji, and it makes him tear up a little bit, and he's like, I love you, buddy, and I'll get through this as long as you're by my side.
He gives you a little like a nuzzle. It's like, oh boy, I'm going to bed now, know what I mean?
It's cool, don't say it back. No, I'm kidding.
Cause I'm some sort of Jason Statham lizard.
Yeah. And he's gonna lay in the hay and just have Benji lay to the side of him.
Benji just kind of plops out like spread eagle on his tummy, and he falls asleep. What y'all doing in here? Inside.
Should somebody go check on Dante, or should we just give him a space, or... Nose goes.
We should give him the space.
We should give him the space. I mean, it's up to you guys. I feel you know him better than I do. You too, Dark. I don't know. Maybe we should just let him relax for the night, but he seems to be beating himself up a lot.
Yes, I do not understand why. We are still young at this, new.
He did promise a little girl that he would save her grandfather.
Yes, I don't know why he did that either. Nothing in this world is for certain. Although I do applaud his drive, I do hope that tomorrow shows us a renewed Dante.
I hope so too.
Well, yeah, I hope so too. But also I hope that he's alive tomorrow, because if they do come to kill him, like, they'll just go to the stables and just kill him, and we'll be in here asleep. So.
Yes, I don't understand why he goes out there either.
Oh, he's weird.
Oh, he's weird.
Darek, do you have enough funds to wash his snot out of your clothing?
Yeah, of course. But, you know, it's not like I could just go get another one made. Have you seen the seamstresses and the blacksmiths and the smiths and all the other makers in this town? I haven't seen them. Because all I see is people playing at it, pretending. It's fine. Whatever.
Really, really dropping the hammer on the Artisan Bray district.
maybe we just all need to sleep. I know I myself could really use some rest.
Yeah, it's been a long day for everybody. We should get some rest.
Before you go to sleep, you should know that DJ Ayers has followed us.
Hey! And Crossbones gave $5 for such wonderful role playing. I award you, hey, hashtag James, one lucky.
Wow.
Thank lucky. You, buddy.
Yeah. Love it.
Jared.
Yar.
This inn that we're, it's not an inn. The
squad house thing?
Yeah, the squad house. How many rooms are there in the squad house?
There's four upstairs. Sorry, there's five upstairs. There's the common area downstairs. And there's the kitchen on the offshoot.
Hmm. And we stay... So the fifth room occupied by...
Brynna has the fifth room, yeah. There's one empty room because James is out in the stables.
Is there a place where Darek could, in theory, find some shut eye, but not be in his room and not necessarily, I mean, obviously if he snores, that's not very stealthy, but he'd like to kind of sleep in a hidden area because he is very cautious about what may happen this evening, just because it's entirely possible that there are people after them.
I mean, the pantry would probably be the, like you could roll up some sacks of flour or something and kind of fashion
it. Yeah, no, that's gross. Okay, you know what, Dark's going to go get a hotel room. Yeah, he's going to go to a hotel for the evening. He's going to go stay somewhere else.
Well, the only inn you know about is over in there. The saltwater.
You make this difficult. Fine. I will go. Everybody just hears a lot of thumping down the stairs as Darek is dragging what would be Dante's bed out down the stairs to the pantry. And then he's going to sleep there.
Okay.
Right then.
I'm going to love it when you wake him up with the chef in the morning at the really early time that it takes to make breakfast for us.
Oh, yeah, no. I'm well, Adam Rady's well aware of that.
Okay, so you all kind of turn in for the evening.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone except Nathan, you have a sleep. It's not completely restful because you had a day. Like Dante's dealing with some stuff. Dark's worried about some attacks. Bilba just doesn't know how to control these crazies at this point. But Nathan, Miramath goes to sleep, and all he dreams about are shadow and fire. Creatures moving about. You see the winged serpent lady in your dream hovering. You see tentacles flailing. You are not in a good place. You get sleep, but it is not restful.
Even though I have elvish immunities to sleep effects?
Yes, that's effects to make you sleep. That's not effects that happen whilst you sleep.
Oh, I got you. Total facial LaFleur.
Yeah. But
are we sure? Because it's an effect that... Okay, you're the one crying. All right.
Just got dumped on.
But you do wake up. Everyone wakes up. When you do wake up, you will have you will be now at your third level.
Woo!
So you've effectively rested to level up.
I leveled up.
Darek is awoken with a spatula kind of poking him in the side.
No, no, thank you. No, it's okay. Turn down service later. Thank you.
You can sleep here if you want, but get off me eggs. Get out the way. I'm going to make breakfast.
Oh, no. Oh, okay. So Dark, like, very drearily, doesn't even open his eyes. He just stumbles around, and he goes back up to his room to go sleep off the rest of the night.
A moment later, you start to hear and smell breakfast cooking down below. And then as you all kind of gather around the table, plates of food, delicious food, are laid out for you.
As Miramath gets ready, he like applies some of the salve underneath his tunic.
You can see that it is starting to fade. It is not... It's not growing, it's starting to recede back in. So.
That's nice.
Does Dante come in for breakfast?
Are the horses back, Jared?
Did I hear they were level 3?
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh, was this news to us?
No.
Oh, right. No, we knew this.
Yeah. You've got your prepared sheet, right?
Yep.
Mm.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm.
Yeah, Dante's gonna come in. It's more Benji being hungry and wanting food than him really needing to eat. But he will show up with Benji and his papoose.
Okay. And no, the horses are not back yet.
Yeah.
But that wouldn't be weird because you know that there's patrol rides out.
It usually takes about 2 days there. It takes
a couple days, yeah.
Yeah.
So you're all gathered around the table. What are you doing now? Where what's your plan entail now that you've slept on it? Are you going after that flail above all?
Not above all.
It's tertiary.
Because I can take that level 3 from you real quick if you go after that flail.
Look, we just got to get in, grab it, and run away. It's fine.
Nothing could go. Yeah, perfect.
Nope.
Perfect.
Nothing could possibly go wrong.
Nope. The tentacles know how to use the flail now.
I mean, I think we had talked about going to the Protectorate.
Yeah, we could set out to go to the Protectorate.
I do not think that's a good idea, but I will listen to you, captains. If what Dark said was correct, and I am marked for death, we're literally walking into a trap.
Well, it's not a trap if you know that it's happening.
Yes,
it's
but
just an encounter you would rather not have.
Have fun with your nether character, Nathan. when we all die.
But I didn't step inside.
I didn't either. I just touched the door.
After a few moments, you hear footsteps coming down the stairs, and Brenna looks exhausted. She plops down in one of the chairs.
Captain, you're back.
Yeah, so are you. What, did you find him?
Yes.
We did.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Over Captain Pike will be thrilled to hear it.
He
not as thrilled.
He's not in the best condition.
Oh, well, I'm sure the doctors will take care of him. What happened out there?
We were set upon by a crystal creature and a black tentacle creature, which seems to have affected his mind.
Wait, you were just supposed to find an old man.
Well, that old man is still an adventurer, Captain.
We found him near the danger.
Well, what did you find, Nyx? The other one missing?
For about 5 minutes, yes.
And then
she took off.
She left us.
During the battle.
She left us to die.
Well, she's an old woman.
She's very good with a dagger.
She is.
This tentacle was unlike anything. I have still been reeling from what it did to me.
Well, I guess I'll read it in your reports.
Oh yes, the paperwork. Did you inform? We've been doing that.
Have you informed over Captain Pike about his father being returned?
We could not find him. There was no time when we delivered the body to the home. They would not take him. We had to take him to the druids.
Oh, that seems quite odd. He's staying at the Aged Brambles with his daughter. I can. I'm due to meet him later.
He was at the Tower of the Protectorate.
Wait, but you were only gone. But a few hours.
We found
the tower's near 2 days away.
We found a portal of some kind that he too had discovered. I mean, I could tell you. Do you want me to just put it in the report, or would you like to hear about it now? Because I could just write it down. You could read it later.
Well, why don't you write it down so I can take it to over Captain Pike at the same time?
Okay.
Or you could give us both a report at the same time. I'm heading over there right after I'm ready.
I would be fine to make the report. The three of you do not need to be there if you are okay with me speaking for us.
It's fine by me.
Hey, that's fine, Mammoth.
Well, I leave in 5. Be ready.
Okay, I go grab my things.
Don't forget your flail. Ooh.
Mm. Hopefully I don't need bludgeoning damage.
So you and under Captain Brenna set out for Aged Brambles, and you're going that way. What are the rest of y'all doing?
Should we head to the Protectorate and meet Miramath there later? I assume we would let you know that before we leave, that we're heading in that direction and you can meet with us.
I mean, I was assuming that you were going to go there, so.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, I guess we would head there then. Unless anybody has any errands to run or shopping to do. Maybe I shouldn't say
Maybe I shouldn't suggest that. I feel like level 3 shopping is something that I'm ready for. No, I mean, Dark will go along with the group. He has no particular distractions in mind.
Okay.
I will lead the way then.
Okay. You head back to the Seclum Ward and back to this building across from the chancel. The Order of the Protectorate. This is a simple and unadorned building, save for 2 armored guards standing at attention on either side of the main entrance. A small garden and pool sit in the front of the building. The garden appears to be grown in the shape of Terraleth itself, with the flowing waters representing the oceans, lakes, and rivers. 6 miniature courts and basalt towers rise from the garden. The door stands open.
I guess we'll just
Is Danuzo in?
Right.
I'm going to look at one of the guards and ask him.
They kind of look at each other. And one of them just kind of gives a head shake to go in.
He'll nod and walk in behind Milva.
Okay.
You walk into this room, and sure enough, it is your friend Danuzo sitting behind a large desk. He stands up. It's like, welcome, friends. What can I do for you?
Oh, Danuzo, it's good to see you again. We have a bit of a problem. We thought maybe we could use you or the rest of the order's help.
Well, I mean, we have very strict strict rules on what we can and can't do, but maybe we can help. What's the problem?
See, that's where things get a little tricky. What has happened may or may not... Do you have a place private for us to chat? Maybe not out in the open here.
Yeah, sure. And he gets up and leads you out into the common garden courtyard.
Well... So we were recently sent on a mission. We were assigned to rescue an older adventurer. He goes by the name of, his name escapes me, Thordis. He was part of the Order many, many years ago. Have you heard the name before?
Oh, you're talking about Thordis Pike? Yes. he was the Grandmaster at one point.
Oh. We've heard he's very strong. He once tamed an owlbear.
Oh, he's done many, many great things before he swore to the Order. He led us well for 30 years.
That's good to hear. Well, he had recently gone missing, and we were tasked to find him. We did find him. The issue is... He was not doing well. He was near one of the towers.
I mean, I could see how he would want to wander back to the towers.
Yes, he was... I look at the other two. He was in the tower when we found him.
as is his right as a sworn order of the protector.
Okay, well, that's good. There was a creature in the tower. I'm not sure if your order is aware of this, but there was a large creature with a tentacle-like creature.
Wait, how do you know what was in the tower?
Well, we went to go rescue him, and...
It flung him through the tower door, exited the tower, and started to attack us.
Yes.
You see Danuzo kind of mutter under his breath and gives a little somatic motion of his hand and comes up. He's like, very well. What describe this creature, please?
Big.
Jared.
Yar.
Can I roll a sense motive on that spell?
Sure.
Because I don't have spellcraft.
I was going to say spellcraft would be better, but...
Yeah, but I don't have spellcraft.
I could do spellcraft, but I didn't really realize... Or, like, I saw it, but...
Sorry. Nope, I don't know nothing about it. It's a 13.
You have a reroll.
I do have a reroll, and gosh darn it, I'm going to use it, Brian Numinator.
Use it!
Count it on the ground. Hold on, I went under the desk.
TTYL. I
hate when that happens.
okay. It's, that's much better. Thank you, Brian Numinator. That's a 24 total on a sense motive.
You don't know the spell that it was, but you can read his body language that it was not aggressive in any way. Like, it wasn't detrimental.
Okay. Copy that. Copy that.
What? So just describe this creature.
Big, giant tentacle lashed onto the onto Pike. Left a mark on him. Very strong. I tried attacking it, and it completely. My arrows didn't work, some of them at least. Very strong. I didn't get a good look at the entirety of the creature, but we at least saw the tentacle.
Oh dear, this is... It's happening faster than we anticipated.
What's happening?
He turns and starts to push you out. He's like, thank you for bringing it to our attention.
No. Wait a minute, Danuzo. Do you know what this creature was? And do you have the means to be able to save that Pike?
We're working on saving the tower. It's
no, I don't care about the tower. I care about Bordas.
I don't care about your cares.
We know.
The well-being of one man means nothing to the well-being of the entire world. The Protectorate will see to the tower.
We know about the winged serpent and the big squid-like creature. At least one of us have seen it.
So you know why we must stop things from happening?
Well, what is it?
You're not sworn Protectorate members. I cannot divulge that information. In fact, I don't even know that information. Only the actual brothers of the Protectorate know. And they're not telling anyone.
So we have to just sit back.
All I know, the piece that I had you acquire for us was intended to reinforce the wards around the tower.
So they're coming from the tower.
They're coming from somewhere. The towers protect us in a way that I don't understand.
Well, is there anything that we can do to help him? Please, we...
One thing got out, at least. There may have been more. The greatest thing you could do would be to hunt these things down and protect the people while the brothers see to the tower. If what I'm guessing is right, there will be many, many creatures of outsider abilities, the likes that we're not prepared for here. It may take all. Whip pan over at Aged Briars.
Yeah.
Miramith stands in front of over Captain Pike, under Captain Brynna, and a wee little dwarven girl. You're back. Have you found my father?
He is alive. He is with the druids at their temple. They would not take him here last night.
Oh, that's disheartening. Why is he at the druids?
Because one of our members is a druid. He went where he knew best after they would not take him here.
That makes sense. What happened? Why was he in need of the healing?
We were at the Tower of the Protectorate. We found Nyx on the ground. She had been giving some sort of sleeping drought, supposedly because he wanted to do whatever it was by himself. We guessed that he was within the tower, and as we went to enter, knowing that it was against their law, he was flung out by a large tentacle, some beast from within. He was unresponsive, though alive, the entire time that we defended him and brought him back. We did not kill the creature, but I myself took the same wounds. I was barely able to pull myself out of it. He saw things. I assume he saw similar things.
Have you told the Protectorate yet?
I believe that may be where my comrades are now.
That he looks to over to Brynna. It's like that is very disheartening, considering the disappearance of the Skystone that you were looking into yesterday, Brynna. I will ride to the Protectorate and talk to them there. You ride to the Potentate and inform them of what is happening. We must tighten defenses, seal gates.
What Skystone do you speak of?
Skystone is the fabled gemstone that was used in the initial construction of the towers. It is required to reattune every few centuries. It hasn't been used in many, many years. That is basically what I know from going through my father's journals. As you may know, sworn order members cannot speak via magic means.
Yes.
So anything outside is all hearsay and speculation. But it does not paint a good picture. Should the towers fail, I fear all else might be next.
Would the Protectorate use the stone to realign the towers?
That would be how I would assume they use it, by channeling their magics through it. I don't know exactly how it works. I know there are six required.
Interesting. Six required.
That's his note said, and the six shall align. It's the only note in there about the actual use of the stones.
What will you have us do? I I will admit I saw visions of creatures attacking our very town of Merst.
I would say inform the protectorate and protect the people. What else really can you do?
I will follow your orders, sir.
I appreciate your swift response. I will ride to the protectorate myself. Brynna to the potentate. If there is something happening, this advance warning may have saved countless lives.
Thank you.
Thank you. And he turns and starts addressing things with Brynna. I think we should take a quick comment break right now. Because
comments?
My dog is flipping out and I have to tend to that. So,
allow us to read for you.
Go, perfect. Read for me.
Earlier, Nathan, Lucas Martinez wanted to know if you can rent a flail.
I think, you know what, it's worth a shot. I did also see Crossbones respond with, then return it with blood on it. I'm sure there's some sort of clause in the rental agreement that you have to clean it, otherwise you will be charged a cleaning fee.
Probably a Santa clause, yeah.
Or more like a sanitization clause.
Oh, you got it. You got it. We had some third level love earlier from Adam Kimbleton.
Boom, boom.
And of course, I wanted to once again shout out that I have to push this button that does that and then this. That this Sunday, Skittermanderers are being given away. Our Starfinder Things in Space show is having an extra show on Sunday, so this isn't the normal show time. This is an extra show that's happening Sunday at 1 p.m. on the Gen Con main stage. Because remember, Gen Con's all digital, and in fact, when I say remember, I'm really talking to the four or five people that are here in chat, because everybody else is already taking part in Gen Con streams. We can tell. All the Gen Con stuff is happening, so when you go back and watch this VOD, it may be too late for you to know that the Skittermanders are being given away.
But we tried to tell you.
We tried. We did our best. We certainly tried.
I also took a bit of personal offense when It's Lucas Martinez said that Danuzo was quoted as saying, Pike is great. He once killed 7 skeletons in one blow.
Well, I mean, you didn't kill any skeletons in one blow, so it's fine.
Well, technically, I killed the one, and then the others.
Oh, so you admitted.
You destroyed it.
And with it, the others. I just said, and that's multiplication or addition or probably both at the same time.
Not sure.
Time.
I math don't think that weird. That's...
Then I technically killed an ant queen because I set its place on fire.
Well, we don't actually see the results. We all saw the results of what I did. We didn't see the results of what you did. They probably had more than one exit, James. It's called a fire escape.
Are you the OSHA for ants?
Maybe you are the OSHA for ants.
But are you the OSHA for ants?
Yeah.
Let's see, what else is happening in the chat?
Okay.
How's the dog, Jared?
She's okay. Apparently people like to leave things on the doorstep and not knock. So just, dog just starts barking without...
Bork, bork.
Like, I don't get to know the reason why she's barking, so...
Well, you figured it out.
I did. Okay, so I assume, Miramath, you head over to meet up with the rest of the group.
I probably head toward the Protectorate. I may see Pike ride by.
Yeah, it's a little like awkward because he said bye and you're both going the same way.
It's one of those things, yeah.
Yeah.
But you get there, and your group of fellows are standing out front, having been shushed out by Danuso. And you arrive.
My friends, if I may, what would you all say to talking to Kirafind, seeing if he has any knowledge? He seems to know other parts of the city.
I think it would be helpful to try at least, because Protectorate, not very helpful. No. I mean, no, we told them what happened and Danuzzo just panicked and said there's not much he can do to help Pike, so...
He did mention the end of the world, so there's that.
He did mention that these visions you had may or may not come true, and we should probably do what we can to help stop it. The towers are protecting us from these creatures, and yeah, so it seems pretty scary.
But the good news, everybody, is that we didn't mess with anything with the Protectorate before this. We didn't throw anything out of whack or out of order. We didn't disturb anything. We are definitely very innocent in all of this.
About that, you know that,
and I like start like doing this of like, let's walk and talk. Let's walk and do
that. Is there something wrong with you? Or are you being possessed? What's happening? Sense motive.
I mean, you could roll a sense motive. I would like to think it would read,
let's go this way.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We should go this way.
All right. Also, Nathan, while you're trying to gather everyone up, give me a perception check.
Perception.
Let's see. Do I have a lucky? Am I sitting on one?
Yeah.
You do.
You know what? Let's use it. Cause who knows, use it or lose it, right? Wait, I gotta use my new. Where's my new mirror math? Mirror math D20. Wow, consistent. It rolled the same thing as last time, and then my other dice rolled the same thing as it, which is an 8. 11.
11. Cool. You gather everyone up and say, "Come over this way." And they start to go that way.
I always love it when it's like, hey, do this thing, and then you don't know what happened.
It's true.
Did it.
I say,
I describe the walking. I follow Miramath. Mm-hmm. Not too close, not too far away. And thus, we walk over there.
Dante's been pretty quiet. What's he up to?
He's just following the group.
He's kind of in his head.
Yeah, he after, I think the Protector rubbed him the wrong way after saying that Pike ran the Protector for 30 years and they give so little care about him. Yeah. That really...
Melville's not happy about that either.
Yeah, Dante took... about all of the patience he had to not say something to him while Milva was talking. And so now he's just thinking about it. And he wishes that we never gave the Protectorate the stone because it seemed like they didn't do anything to help.
Adam Rady doesn't think we gave the Protectorate the stone. But we're about to find out.
You've gathered them up, Nathan.
You know that object we acquired?
Yes. The smoothie from the King Fruit King?
No. The other one.
Okay. Okay.
With the art.
Oh, my new shirt? It does have an awesome floral pattern on it, but I don't feel like it's too gaudy and it doesn't stand out too much.
Do the other two of you understand what I am saying at least?
Yes, I know when we are very tiny.
Yes.
Oh, the star. Okay, yeah.
That is apparently something used to realign towers.
Mm-hmm.
And the potentate has been investigating where it has gone.
Uh,
I wonder where it could have gone.
Yes. If it is where it should be, the Protectorate should be able to use it to stop any problems. But if it is not where it should be, then
I've been thinking about that a little bit. I've been thinking about that. So the Protectorate can't speak. And so didn't you guys have somebody who talked to you a whole lot about how they needed the thing? Also, why didn't the Protectorate have the thing that they always use to align their towers?
Well, if I remember history correctly, it was acquired by the Potentate before they were the Potentate and was kind of like an heirloom that they locked away because... But I don't remember how they got it, but they had it.
And as far as the Protectorate, only the Brotherhood are the ones that take the Vow of Silence. The other members are still allowed to talk, such as Denuzo, but the higher ranking members are the ones that do not speak,
except for
spell means.
You know, I was just spitballing, you know, just trying to come up with something.
No,
okay, yeah, right. Whatever your plan is, let's do it, Miramath.
I just think we should talk to Kirafind.
Right.
Go
Kira.
I agree.
Fiend. Yep.
The elf.
I know.
With the silver hair.
Oh. Right. Yeah. No, I know exactly who that is. Yeah. Uh huh.
Who?
Oh, you.
Oh, right.
We're talking to horses.
How do you know that?
You kind of always talk to horses. It's kind of like your thing.
Okay. Yeah. I'll give you that one. Yeah. Who?
Kirafind, he is a choir of goods.
So with a smuggler?
You know,
it may not be as black and white as we thought.
He helps people. He
yes, I was surprised by it. Thought he was bad. Turns out might not be. Very confused.
Right. Our buddy, the bar buddy. Yeah, no, let's go see him. Yeah, can we get a drink too?
I could use a drink now more than ever.
We could see if he's, you know, doing a dealing at the the shady bar. My favorite.
We could also just swing by his place. I mean, we...
No, I heard drink, and now that is all I can think about at the moment.
Okay, but if he's not there, we're going to go to his place.
I can take you to my favorite place.
You can go to his place. I will be drinking my sorrows away.
It's not very much of a team player, Dante. You said that you wanted to stick by us and be able to defend us and defend this city. We need you to come with us. You're, like, super strong.
You carried that dwarf for, like, 8 hours.
Yeah, you carried a dwarf for like 16 hours straight. It was crazy.
Okay, one drink, and then we're fine to go if he's not there.
Yeah, you have one drink. Mm-hmm.
That's fine with me.
So you head to the Blue Blade. It's pretty empty. It's pretty early in the morning. You do walk in. And let me think. I gotta find my note on who ran it. The female half elf behind the bar welcomes you in. Welcome. She smokes. Welcome. little early to be drinking, but what do you want?
Your strongest rum, if you have it.
I got some fey wine. It's like rum.
That's
super potent.
That's fine with me. I'll take three.
Have you seen Kirafind today?
Kirafind hasn't been in maybe a week now since the beating.
What?
Since the beating?
Oh yeah, he and his folks took a beating on a deal gone wrong a couple nights back.
What?
Is he at his place?
Probably resting and recuperating, yeah.
Told you we should have gone to his place. Shoot.
Can I do a perception check to see who's in the bar right now?
Sure.
While you're doing that perception check, giving a quick shout out to the Faceless King 101. It's been 6 months since I've been able to watch live, and I have to go to work in 45 minutes, but they have just subscribed for the 6th month. Thank you so much. It is amazing. Thank you, the Faceless King. I hope you are able to catch up in VODs, and I hope you enjoy the short amount of time you're able to tune in now, and you know, be safe at work.
I'm going to use my lucky because that was a natural 1. 20.
No. You can't do that.
I called it before.
You got to call the lucky ahead of time.
Fuck.
Rules.
Well, the people in the bar that you see, there's a kind of full of himself human in very nice clothes.
Keep going. I want to hear your descriptions.
There's an armored and frustrated elf walking around.
That's just me. Right.
There's a very concerned yet over it ranger.
Hey, I see where you're going here.
I'm a little... And then there's this little tubby fat lizard hanging out on some dude's chest.
It's just us.
So I'm gonna go up to the guy in the armor and hand him a drink and go, "Hey, what brings you in a place like this?"
We came here together, but thank you.
Yeah, you got me. I'm a little drunk right now. I've had two of these.
Yeah, they're very potent.
If we're gonna go, one for the road, I guess.
No, he's good.
I shoot the one
he gave me.
Oh.
Okay. Woo!
Dark's just snacking on the pretzels and the peanuts.
I follow it with a health potion.
Milva, you want one? I'm buying. All round for the bar!
It's the four of us.
I'm buying.
Hey, if you're buying, I'll take one too.
Around for the bar, Marky.
I just gotta say, I like the choice. When confronted with the option to help save the world, you guys go to the bar. I like it.
We were looking for information, and in our defense, the group didn't want our help saving the world.
It's amusing to me.
How much does it cost me for 4 more fey?
About 3 silver each.
Cool. So like a gold and a half.
Yeah. And Arafel is very excited because it's 10 in the morning and she's not used
to it. He's already made his day.
Yeah. She's good for...
I'm going to tell her to keep the change, which is 5 gold or 5 silver. And go, "Woo, let's go see this elf guy."
Jared, our cure light wounds are +1, right?
3.
Oh! Look at there.
Yeah.
Okay, so I took one of mine because I'm still not at 100% and I just drank. So I was like, I did a potion chaser.
Got it.
Am I going to have any minuses for being drunk, Jared?
Not that apply right now.
Cool. I will hold myself to it if we get into combat.
Would you all be... I think we should check on Kid a Fiend.
I think you should check on Kid a Fiend.
You are such a lightweight, Dante. Come on.
Benji, you want one? Rather Benji!
Yeah, go. I start like leading everyone and like kind of like guiding James out.
You meander through the alley, or through the roadways and the alleys back to the house, and there appears to be some sort of fire lit in the fireplace.
I just want to say, you guys are my best friends, and I don't know what I'd do without you.
Oh boy, we're at that stage.
I love you guys so much.
I like gently pat Dante on the shoulder. They're there.
Thanks.
He's probably got to find a corner to evacuate.
Dante immediately pukes when you tap him on the back.
Oh, God.
He goes, don't eat that, Benji. We're going.
You're at Kira Finn's house.
I knock.
A little old lady opens the door. Like a little gnomish lady.
She's like, yes?
Hello, we are looking for Kirafin.
Yes, Master Kirafin is resting upstairs. I don't know why I sound like a goat.
Wow, we'll just go up there then.
And I move past her.
No, can I do like a... I want to stop him.
Yeah, you throw your arm out to try and slow him down.
Acrobatics.
He sure. runs into it. I sink.
Okay, you got me there. You got me.
Your dad gave me that one.
if you wait in the parlor, I'll tell Master Kirafin you're here. Who am I say is calling?
Miramath Berior. I spoke with him a little while back. We came to his door shortly after he had returned home.
Oh, okay. That's
tell him it's the other elf he knows.
I'll tell him.
She.
And Benji. She tell him Benji's here.
He doesn't know Benji.
Everyone knows Benji.
Milva, can you take him to a different town?
A different town. You know what, Dante? Maybe we should take a walk around.
Just take a lap.
Block. Yeah, take a lap.
Just take a lap.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This sounds nice. It's a nice day.
Yeah, it's, you know, only 11, you know? It's still pretty early in the day.
Sometimes I talk like this to be confident.
No. Oh, God. All right, let's go.
After a few moments, you hear the sound of a cane and footsteps coming down the stairs, and standing in the doorway is your silver hair, pale blue-eyed friend, Kirafin, with his head is wrapped, and he's got one arm in a sling, and his left leg is in some sort of brace.
My friend.
Miramath, good to see you.
What happened to you?
Oh, business deal gone awry. I trusted those whom I shouldn't have.
I am very sorry. Can Tarik and I come in?
Sure.
Hi.
Come, have a seat. Would you like some tea? Or maybe some pickle juice?
I am fine. Tarik?
Oh, yeah, I would like some tea, and if you could just warm up just a splash of milk, I'd like it at about room temperature when it's poured in, just steep once with the tea. I don't need it steeped multiple times. Thank you.
Because nothing's better than room temperature milk.
Yeah. No, when you pour it in to the tea, it's hot tea.
The little old gnomish lady goes back towards the kitchen.
What can I do for you today, Mammoth?
Have you heard any tell of otherworldly beings around town or unexplained happenings?
Oh, yeah. What Miramath's trying to ask is, have you heard anything about the Protectorate? And maybe they were looking for something or lost something.
I mean, I always hear about the Protectorate. Those silent old men are always up to lecherous deeds. And they always need things acquired for them. And I acquire it. As far as strange creatures, no more than normal, but again, I've been laid up for almost a week now.
Yes, these happenings, while I know you try to work, shall we say, for the good, was this something that others were working for evil?
Jared?
Yar?
I want to roll a sense motive on his injuries. I know that would probably normally be a heal check, but I don't have heal, so do sense motive. I don't know if he's really hurt or if this is...
a ruse?
A ruse. 17?
He's either really hurt or a really good actor.
Got like
he's wincing at the right times. And
I used the lucky on that one, by the way. I'm sorry I didn't say that, but I did. I'm going to mark it off.
Well, I mean, it stands to reason that there are smugglers. I do know some smugglers that don't use their moral choice when taking assignments.
What about, what did he look like, Mirmath, the one that took the stone thing?
The who, the what?
Oh, you know, the one that you made the deal with to go steal a thing, and then you gave it to him. What did he look like?
That's why you were at the party. You were after a piece of the sky stone.
A piece of? I thought it was... Oh, no, there are six pieces. Yes, of course.
What he means is, oh, no, what sky stone? What are you talking about?
Yes. I'm not good at lying.
Well, I assume you got it successfully.
Not without resistance. Others were trying to steal it as well. We're really trying to just steal it for the betterment. You know, steal it before other bad people stole it.
Something
like the Declaration of Independence.
Yes.
Oh, there's a map on the back.
There was a map on the back. We didn't even check for the map.
And a legend. A cipher, if you will.
Stealing things to protect them is something near and dear to my heart. It actually aligns with why I do what I do. But sadly, the piece that you stole or borrowed or protected, whatever you have to tell yourself to sleep at night, had been stolen decades ago. In its place, it was just a reasonable facsimile. That's common underworld knowledge.
Wait, you're saying that what we stole wasn't actually what we thought we stole?
Correct, just a very well-done forgery.
Then where, pray tell, is the original?
That is the 100 gold question, isn't it?
All right, give him 100 gold, Mirmath.
I do have 100 gold. Do you have the answer?
I do not.
Okay, well then I wouldn't pay. You understand.
Yes.
I appreciate your honesty, though.
Perhaps sarcasm will be removed from our conversations in the future.
Sarcasm. I've never been there. Is it a large gap?
He just looks over at Dark. It's like, really?
Takes things at face value.
It was replaced decades ago when he became potentate. I don't know what happened to the original piece. I'm sure it's floating around somewhere, trying to be sold or moved or...
If everybody knew it was a fake, then why did this person want it stolen?
Not everyone knew it was just the underground.
Because whoever... Why would you have guarded a fake also? The owner themselves didn't know.
Yes, that's... He always was an idiot. So his daughter's much brighter and runs things much better. now that he's old and dying.
Well, okay then.
I suggest if you're trying to pick up the trail of the Skystone, maybe start with her.
Interesting.
We should go talk to the woman we robbed.
Yes. I'm wondering if we mentioned the fact that we robbed her. But yes.
Well, it's not good to lie, Miramath.
No, it's not lawful either.
I do appreciate your visit, brother, and checking on me is well appreciated.
Of course. And I will lay my hand on him and just say, I pray that your recovery is a quick and smooth one. And I will use a lay on hands in that moment.
All right.
So that is now a D6 plus one because of my leveling up.
Whoa.
I know, right? Let's see. Watch me get a good old two healing for him. No, it's seven.
He gets a very, very big spring in his step. He's, oh, thank you. That feels delightful. We should visit together more often.
Yes. Well, consider it a thanks for all the information you have provided us.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got bed rest, or else Nana will yell.
Yes, we wouldn't want Nana to yell.
No, she's small, but she's mighty.
As most Nanas are.
And at this point, she comes back in with the teas.
Oh, right. I guess we'll drink these very quickly.
Yes, you can feel free to entertain yourselves. I'm going to begin my arduous climb up the stairs.
Darek, would you like to play some gin rummy while we wait with our tea?
No.
Meanwhile, outside, Milva's trying to steer a drunk Dante around.
Yeah.
He's in the.
I've like people on the streets like looking at him. He's all right. He's all right.
He's in that part where you get just drunk enough to start dancing.
Yeah, like he's like, let's go to a.
let's go to a club. I just want to dance. I just want to dance.
There's no clubs open. It's 11 a.m. We're just gonna walk this off. You'll be all right.
Oh, no clubs. Oh. Also impending doom of the world.
Yeah.
Also that. Captain, I just want to dance.
Soon you'll be at the stage where you get really hungry and we'll have to take you to get some food. Just waiting for that stage.
Food does start to sound good right now.
Well, perhaps we can go circle back one more lap and then check on the others.
Oh, I'm gonna dance around the lap.
That's fine, I suppose. If you need to, go ahead and dance.
Tracy,
dance if you want to.
Give me a perception check.
Oh boy.
Be better than mine.
Perception. At least I'm good at that. I want to use my lucky. I have one. And I'm about to lose it. So, oh, good. 18. 24.
24. You're trying to steer Dante around and make sure he doesn't like fall over himself and hurt himself. He's almost at the point where like your drunk friend escapes. No one can handle him.
Is he? I thought you were watching him, Benji.
Yeah, we've all been there. When you
Benji
glance up,
is, like,
and you
still
see
wrapped in the papoose.
Yeah, he's
round.
Just going along.
The papoose is off.
Yeah, you see a small human child in rags and very very run down clothing, turn, lock eyes with you. And then vanish into a building's wall. Just passes right through the wall.
I do like a double take. Did you see that, Dante?
Huh?
And we will have to figure out what is up with our wayward child.
Next week. And nobody's gonna believe me when I tell them because Dante was dancing.
It's true. Dante's a good dancer, though.
Thank you.
So that is our you've saved the old man, kinda, for now.
Yeah. He's not officially dead.
It's true.
And what more could you really want?
You found out about the mugging a little bit.
We did. Yeah. We learned about that.
Yeah.
We learned that the thing we stole was a fake.
It's fake.
It's true.
That was a twist.
Yeah.
That was a twist. What a twist.
An unfortunate twist.
So the question still remains
for that fake.
Did Danuzzo do it or not? That's the question.
Interesting.
Yeah. Well,
he proclaims his innocence here in chat. He's like, I didn't do nothing.
I think he did. He did something.
In the meantime, T Terra G has followed. So thank you so much for the follow.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
We are approaching 2,800 followers on the channel. And
what?
We're almost to 60,000 channel views. Nice.
That's awesome. Wow.
Pretty cool.
Thank you so much, guys. That's awesome. That wouldn't be possible without you.
Yeah.
Pretty incredible.
That is huge.
Thank you, everyone.
That is huge.
Huge.
Sorry you didn't get to play with your level threes very much.
Yeah, not really.
Now you have
them. I mean, I was really looking forward to it.
Yeah, I knew coming in once I saw what was going on with the prep. I was like, oh, Rady's not going to have that guy ready yet.
It's okay. I have him in PC gen, and it doesn't take much time at all in PC gen.
And we got 3 weeks to play with him.
Yeah. I mean, exactly. Unless this small child kills you. Who knows?
Well, there's that. Probably will.
There is that.
Probably will.
It's true.
We got three more episodes left of Bedlam and Discord quarantine contingencies.
Season one.
You did it.
Season one.
And as a reminder, everybody, we have Things in Space on Saturday and on Sunday. Things in Space on Saturday, of course, 6 p.m. Pacific time, as normal. I believe they have a new guest star on Saturday, and they have a new guest star on Sunday. I don't want to spoil anything for them, so I won't give those things away. On Sunday, they are giving away things for Skittermanners, thanks to Paizo, for their Gen Con stream. That stream on Sunday will not be on this channel. I mean, we will be hosting it, so you can come here and watch it. But if you want to be part of the action, make sure you go over to twitch.tv/GenConMainStage. The link is down below, and you will have a chance to win one of four Skittermander dice pouches that are being given away. They are adorkables.
I want it.
A chance to check that out. And then on Monday, Crits and Giggles is back with episode 3 of season 2. Dat Family Time happens on Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific. We all hang out. Yesterday. Wow. Time is meaningless now in the world, as we all know.
It's true.
Just yesterday, we all cooked dinner together. It was a really good time. And then next Wednesday, we're back with more Bedlam and Discord. Sorry, Jared, if I stole your thunder, but I know sometimes...
As long as that information gets out,
yep,
I'm a happy camper.
Now, Rady, those Skittermanders... Now, usually cast... Right, I can't. But significant others.
Well, here's the thing. We're not cast on Things in Space.
See?
That's true.
No, and we'll, of course, be outlawing all of James's bonuses in the future. We'll be taking steps to remedy the situation.
What the hell?
We're gonna get some other account. He's just gonna create another account that nobody knows about.
Fake account.
Wow, we've got this new follower. Welcome,
Dante is best.
Someone said Dante the floor puncher.
Yes.
So you might be saying that.
I will also be releasing high res single photos on the Instagram and Twitter of the art that was done here.
So, oh, not photos of singles. Okay. No, you meant single photos. Okay.
Single photos. Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah. Sorry. And I will, in addition, I will continue with my weird face smush ups.
Please do not. Please stop.
They excite me.
No, that's the opposite.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
We'll see. We'll see. We'll see how they go.
Poorly.
I think that wraps it up for us here at the DAT Network and Bedlam and Discord. So we will see you on Saturday for Things in Space.
Things in Space.
We're raiding somebody. Who's it going to be? I don't know. We'll figure it out. Bye, everybody. Bye. Enjoy your week.
Bye.
Have fun.
See ya.
Bye.